not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedom.
Human beings from the planet Earth, and those of you that support Exposed CPS, and those of you that need to know about us. I don't know, maybe a month and a half ago or so, you know, things at home were really stressful for me, especially with my middle son. Coming into his teenage years, he's exhibiting some swings of aggression, possible bipolar. His mom was, so that's understandable. But, you know, and all the kids, just teenage boys being rebellious, it's been pretty exhausting. So I did contact this DHS office, because I give everybody one chance, you know, and even though I know CPS is corrupt and evil and all those things, I said maybe they have some resources in the community that would help. So, I don't know, it took over a week for them to even respond, and then when I did talk to the lady you're about to listen to, Stacy Wood, she promised to get back to me in 2 days, never did, didn't hear from her for 9 or 10 days till I called her supervisor. And she wants to have her closing notes now. And so I thought I'd play the audio for you guys, especially those of you that may not know how to handle these people and are intimidated by them. You need to know your rights, and you're going to get stressed out with your kids. But there are people out there, whether it be in your community, myself, or on the internet, that are willing to help you through it. So don't contact these bastards. They're evil. Stand up against them. And this is how I handled the situation when Miss Wood just called me.
This is Stacy Wood from Yandere County Child Welfare. How are you?
I'm doing okay.
Good. I am calling because I still have not met with you.
And you're still not going to.
Not going to meet with you?
No, you're not. Absolutely not.
Okay. Would you be willing to come into our office?
For what reason?
To meet, so that I can complete my assessment.
So that you can complete your assessment. So now it's important, because you have a protocol to follow. But when I reached out to you guys, you failed to keep your promises. The situation at home has been handled by myself, as it always has been for 11 years. I contacted you over a month ago, ma'am. And I have your messages saved, date and time, response times, and everything else. That's against you personally and your failures. Now, as a failure from your organization, if you might call it, I've also contacted DHS 4 or 5 times in relation to a young female that I'm housing. Nobody's responded to that either. It's quite apparent that DHS is not willing nor able to help my family. So your protocol and your closing notes can go to hell. If you think there's reason to get a warrant, you go do that. I'd be happy to come to court with a warrant after you prove your case to a judge. And not that I have to tell you, but this call is being recorded, as all calls are recorded with public officials.
Okay.
So you have a nice day, and do not bother me again unless you have a warrant. Do not come to my home unless you have a warrant. Do you understand me?
I do.
Thank you.
Yep.
The corrupt fear us, the noble join us, and the wise will always expect us. Much love from Op Expose.